Socrates once said, "My way towards the truth is to ask the right questions." Dr. Frankl adopts methods from philosophy itself. We shall now look at the third logotherapeutic technique, which is adapted from the famous philosopher Socrates. It is called Socratic dialogue. Now we must appreciate that nearly all forms of psychotherapy is dialogue. The therapist and the client talk to one another, but this conversation is different from how we talk to each other in our daily lives. I would like to illustrate this example with a client that I had. He had been recommended for professional help many times, mostly due to his anger and aggression. Think of talking to this person Socratically. But before that, you must learn the following. Ignorance. As Socrates say, "All I know is that I know nothing." Here we forget about any previous explanations or assessment we may have of this person's aggressive behavior. We do not know why this person is angry, and in our conversation we shall learn it by asking rather than assuming. Just like a child who asks why constantly to every answer, we too shall take this approach and keep on diving deeper, but by asking clarification for the answers given or questioning the assumptions. By doing this, we often learn more about our lack of knowledge or contradictions in our words. So with that in mind, here's how the conversation went with the client. I asked, "Why do you feel angry?" To which he answered,
"I don't know, I just do."
"Does it bother you that you do not know why you feel angry?"
"Yeah."
"Would you like to share with me?"
"Because I feel like I can't control myself. Something ticks me off and sometimes I feel like it shouldn't, but it does, and I just lose it. Or sometimes people who don't like me do it deliberately because they know that they can."
As you can see here in this case, by not assuming, we learn more. But if we had made an assumption about why this person feels angry, we would not have gotten their own interpretation of it. Now let's talk about why use Socratic dialogue. Logotherapy suggests to treat your client as if he, she or they is a philosopher in their own right, and their problem is philosophical in nature. This makes logotherapy very flexible. Dr. Frankl says that the future of logotherapy is in the hands of those who use it. He encourages them to develop it further and not make his words the final one. We can see the effects of these if we look at the success rate of logotherapy in a notoriously difficult psychological condition to treat, and that is addiction. It is surprising how effective logotherapy is compared to other forms of psychotherapy and treatment, and a very important part that plays in that success is because logotherapists often use Socratic dialogue as their form of communication with the client. It does two things at the same time. Firstly, through Socratic dialogue, we are saved from stereotyping the nature of the person's problem. We learn firsthand the nature of their problem and from the best source available to us as therapists. This issue may not seem very big to adults, but think of it in context when the client isn't the one in a position of power, such as a child. Think about a child who may have a very different outlook to their problem as compared to their parent. The second most important point of using Socratic dialogue is that the client learns along with you. Oftentimes, we are not aware of why do we believe what we believe or do what we do. We do like to think of ourselves as being in control of our behavior, but much of the research shows that we are actually not. When we engage in Socratic dialogue, we come across the basis of our beliefs and behaviors. Here I would like to share my client from before. In the middle of our therapy, we came across an interesting point. He shared with me that he thinks of the world as a hostile place and is mostly aggravated because he puts in most of his time into working and making money for his family. Whenever he feels that someone is a hurdle in that process, and by his account most people were, he would feel very angry. So I asked him, "But why do you work so much?"
"So my kids can have a better life than I did."
"And money makes that possible?"
"What else does?"
"I am not sure, but what do you think?"
"Of course, I barely saw my parents because we were poor. They had to work to the bone to get me where I am. And I don't want my kids to experience that."
"Experience what?"
"That kind of childhood."
"But they barely see you. Just like you said, you barely saw your parents." This made him pause and think about it. I wanted to include this part because of the third point that we must note. The Socratic dialogue in logotherapy isn't for its own sake. It's not just a philosophical exercise, but a therapeutic one as well. It has a goal. And in this case, we reach to the source of his anger. If you recall our previous video on dereflection, this client was hyper-focused on providing for his family, and this hyper-intention was so high that he was mostly away from his family, causing him to be in a negative state of mind. The client may not have been aware of this factor had we not gone through the process of Socratic dialogue. Dr. Frankel believed in the blend of different forms of therapy. That means using logotherapeutic approach in other forms of therapy as well. So therapists of other school of thoughts are encouraged to benefit from it. I hope it was helpful and would be helpful in your professional practices or daily social interactions. We welcome your feedback and request you to please let us know in the comments if you would want us to focus on a certain problem. We would follow up this video with a detailed breakdown of the logotherapeutic Socratic method very soon.